Julian Evans. Let's get you informed. Now, schools are expected to reopen for second term this week amidst numerous challenges posed to teachers, learners, and parents. Some of these challenges include raging floods in various parts of the country, threats by intern teachers to disrupt resumption of studies, and the Transport Ministry having maintained that it will enforce a directive requiring school buses and vans to undergo inspection in order to ferry learners. Our reporter Vera Mora kickstarts our broadcast tonight.
To many schools, 29th of April 2024 will mark their first day of term 2 during this academic year. However, parents are a bit skeptical about releasing their children to school. With the threats of landslides and waterborne diseases looming large, the safety of learners is of paramount concern. What is more worrying is the heavy rains pounding the country, leaving a trail of destruction that has also affected schools. In Busia County, learning in 8 schools is at risk of being disrupted due to the destructions caused by ongoing rainfall. Sikinga Primary School in Nambale sub-county faced a significant challenge, as strong winds have destroyed 10 classrooms, leaving over 600 learners to share 4 remaining classrooms. Namabusi Secondary Schools, Butalangi, Musoma, Runyu, Madua, and Iranya Primary School are completely submerged due to backflow.
Kulikuwa na vifaa vya wanafunzi, hasa sana chekechea, gredi ya kwanza, ya pili, ya tatu na nne, kwa sababu vifaa vyao huwa vinabaki darasani. Hivyo vifaa, kwa sababu ya mvua nyingi, hatujaweza kuvipata.
Watoto walikuwa nyumbani, wangekuwa hapa wamejikinga mvua, tungekuwa na shida hata zaidi.
Transport Cabinet Secretary Kipchumba Murkomen and NTSA Director General George Njao instructed all school buses to undergo mandatory inspection at the NTSA yard before institutions reopen, making sure all vehicles are in good condition and the drivers are well skilled.
Today it was mainly a clinic, a reminder that road safety actually is for all of us and should be adhered to at all times.
Mefuzo mambo ya speedy. Mabaya ya kukosa kuheshimiana kwa barabara, tukafundishwa mambo ya maintain gari. Kianza kuanza safari, tunahakikisha ile gari tunaendesha iko salama.
Even though Basic Education Principal Secretary Belio Kipsang say that school opening dates will remain as scheduled, former Cabinet Secretary Minister of Defense Eugene Wamalwa urges that floods may necessitate a delay.
Ingekuwa vyema kwa hali hii kama serikali could have considered postponing the opening of schools, sababu hali iko mbaya sana. Wengi ambao wamepoteza maisha ni watu wazima. Shule zikifunguliwa kwa hali hii, watoto watakuwa hatarini.
Travel disruptions have already occurred with road closure and alternative routes advised. And this also threatens safety of learners during school's reopening. Learners expected to use Nakuru-Nairobi Highway may be affected as transport between Kijabe and Maimayu has been cut off after fallen logs and rocks block the road because of mudslides in the Kijabe forest.
Hii daraja si mara ya kwanza kuvunjika. Imevunjika 10 years ago. Kwa sababu maji yote ya kutoka juu huko Geshiango huko juu yote inakujanga hapa.
Wakati Maimai kumekuwa na msogomano wa magari kama siku ya leo, huwa tunatumia hii daraja na hii barabara inatufikisha upande wa Kimende.
Hata hatujui shule zinakuwa open next week. Na hata ile imewekwa hapa ni very temporary, ikikuja mvua ingine imeenda.
The other factor that is brewing a crisis is a strike threatened by 46,000 intern teachers, which threatens to disrupt learning in public schools. Junior Secondary School intern teacher spokesperson Bonface Omari on Saturday said the tutors will not report on duty on Monday. Vera Mora, KTN News, Nairobi.
Now, still on the floods watch, more than 90.